last session we have discussed about some of the important chemical properties of water, structure of water and structure of ice. In today's session, now I am going to discuss about the last part of this chapter, that is hard and soft water. Okay, let's begin. Depending upon the behavior of water towards the soap solution with respect to lather formation, water can be divided into two types, that is hard water and soft water. What is hard water? The water which contains calcium and magnesium salts in it is called hard water. If the calcium and magnesium salts present in the water, then that water is called hard water. Hard water does not produce the lather with the soap ready. Lather means froth or foam. Okay. The hard water does not produce lather with the soap ready. The sea water and lake water, they are all hard in nature. They come under this category. Now, what is soft water? Soft water is nothing but the water which is free from these calcium and magnesium salts. That means the water which do not contain calcium and magnesium salts in it is called soft water. Okay. Now, why the water becomes hard? What is the cause of the hardness of water? The answer is because of the presence of the salts like calcium bicarbonate, magnesium bicarbonate, calcium chloride, magnesium chloride, calcium sulfate, magnesium sulfate. Because of the presence of these salts will cause the hardness in the water. If any of these salts present in the water, then the water will become hard. Okay. Now, I have told you that hard water does not produce lather with the soap readily. Why? That's because the calcium and magnesium ions present in the hard water will react with the soap and form the precipitation or scum, so that hard water does not produce lather with the soap readily. But once all the calcium and magnesium ions has precipitated out, then the water becomes soft and produce lather. But to precipitate out all the calcium and magnesium ions, a large quantity of soap is required, and most of the soap will be wasted in the form of precipitation. Hence, this hard water is not suitable for washing purpose. Okay. So this is about the hard and soft water. Now, let us discuss about the types of hardness. There may be two types of hardness based on the there may be two types of hardness present in the water. They are types of hardness. First one is temporary hardness. Temporary hardness. And second one is permanent hardness. Permanent hardness. There may be two types of hardness present in the water. Now let us discuss about them one by one. What is temporary hardness? If the hardness of the water is caused by the presence of calcium bicarbonate and magnesium bicarbonate, that type of hardness is called temporary hardness. That means if hardness of the water is caused by the presence of bicarbonates of calcium and magnesium, then that type of hardness is called temporary hardness. If these two salts present in the water, they cause temporary hardness. And why this is called temporary hardness? Because it can be easily removed just by boiling and filtering the water. Now, let us discuss about the methods to remove the temporary hardness in the water. I will discuss about this permanent hardness later. Now, let us see the methods to remove temporary hardness in water. There are two methods to remove the temporary hardness in the water. Before that, the process of removal of from the water, or the process of conversion of hot water into soft water is called softening of water. So to soften the temporary water, there are two methods. The first one is boiling method. Yes, if we boil the hot water, then the salts present in this temporary hot water, that is calcium bicarbonate and magnesium bicarbonate, will decompose and form the calcium carbonate and magnesium carbonate respectively. Let me write the equation. Calcium bicarbonate, magnesium bicarbonate, when we boil the temporary hot water, the calcium bicarbonate and magnesium bicarbonate present in that water will convert it into calcium carbonate and magnesium carbonate respectively. And these calcium carbonate and magnesium carbonates are insoluble salts. Okay? Since they are insoluble salts, they can be easily removed just by filtering. Okay? We cannot remove these calcium bicarbonate and magnesium bicarbonate from the water by filtering. Why? Because they are soluble salts. But after boiling, they get converted into insoluble salts like calcium carbonate and magnesium carbonate, and they can be easily removed by filtering. Thus, the water which we obtain after boiling is soft in nature. So, this is the first method to remove the temporary hardness of water. Now, let's move on to the second method to remove the temporary hardness. That is Clark's method. Clark's method. In Clark's method, calcium hydroxide or slaked lime is added to the water. Calcium hydroxide is also called as slaked lime. Okay. This calcium hydroxide is added to the water. Then the calcium bicarbonate and magnesium bicarbonates which are present in the hot water will react with this calcium hydroxide and give calcium carbonate and magnesium hydroxide respectively. Let me write the equation. When this calcium bicarbonate reacts with the calcium hydroxide and give calcium carbonate, magnesium bicarbonate will react with this calcium hydroxide and gives calcium carbonate plus magnesium hydroxide. That will react with the calcium bicarbonate and magnesium bicarbonates present in the hot water and convert them into calcium carbonate and magnesium hydroxides. These calcium carbonate and magnesium hydroxides, they are insoluble salts. Okay. Since they are insoluble salts, they can be easily removed by filtering. Hence, the water becomes soft. So, these two are the methods to remove the temporary hardness of water. Now, let's move on to the other type of hardness, that is permanent hardness. Now, let us discuss about the permanent hardness of water. If the hardness of water is caused by the presence of chlorides and sulfates of calcium and magnesium, then that hardness is called permanent hardness. The salts like calcium chloride, calcium sulfate, magnesium chloride, magnesium sulfate, they cause us permanent hardness in the water. If any of these salts present in the water, then then water will become permanently hard. Okay. This is called permanent hardness because it cannot be easily removed by boiling and filtering, unlike the temporary hardness. Okay. Now let us discuss about the methods to remove the permanent hardness in water. There are four methods to remove the permanent hardness in water. The first one is washing soda process. What is washing soda? Washing soda is nothing but sodium carbonate, Na2CO3. Na2CO3. Sodium carbonate is the chemical name of washing soda, and washing soda is the common name of the sodium carbonate. In this method, we are going to add calculated amount of sodium carbonate into the hard water. Then the salts, the magnesium and calcium salts present in the hard water will react with the sodium carbonate and gives the calcium carbonate and magnesium carbonates respectively. Here, observe here, I have written down the equations. The calcium salts like calcium chloride and calcium sulfate, they react with sodium carbonate and gives the calcium carbonate. And the magnesium salts like magnesium chloride and magnesium sulfate, they react with sodium carbonate and gives the magnesium carbonate. And you know that the calcium carbonate and magnesium carbonates are insoluble salts. Since they are insoluble salts, they can be easily removed by filtering. Thus, the water will become soft. So, this is about washing soda process. Now, let's move on to the second method of removing permanent hardness in water. That is Colgan's method. What is Colgan? Colgan is nothing but Na6T6O18. Its chemical name is sodium hexametaphosphate. Sodium hexametaphosphate. This sodium hexametaphosphate is commercially called as Colgan. Okay. In this method, we are going to add this Colgan to the hard water, and these reactions will take place in that. The first step is the Colgan, that is sodium hexametaphosphate, will undergo ionization and produce the sodium ion and the complex anion. And in the second step, the calcium and magnesium ions present in the hot water will combine with this complex anion and replace the sodium ion from it and give the insoluble substance. Here, M represents calcium or magnesium. Instead of writing for both calcium and magnesium, simply I have written it as M. Okay. So when we add the Colgan to the water, the Colgan undergo ionization and produce the sodium ion and the complex anion. That complex anion will combine with the calcium and magnesium ions present in the hot water and gives the insoluble substance. Since it is insoluble, it can be easily removed by filtering. Thus, the water will become free from calcium and magnesium ions, hence becomes soft. So, this is about the Colgan's method. Now, let's move on to the third method of removing the permanent hardness of water, that is ion exchange method. Ion exchange method. This method is also called as zeolite method or permutate method. In this method, we are going to use a compound, that is NaAlSiO4. Its name is sodium aluminium silicate. So in this ion exchange method, we are going to use this compound, sodium aluminium silicate. And this is also called as zeolite. This compound is also called as zeolite. Since we are using this zeolite in this process, the name of this process is also called as zeolite method. Okay. And for the sake of simplicity, we can write this sodium aluminium silicate as NaZ. Okay. Here, this AlSiO4 is replaced by the letter Z. This is pretty big compound, right? So, it will be difficult to use the whole molecular formula in the equations. Hence, we can simply write When it is added to the hot water, the calcium and magnesium ions present in the hot water will combine with the zeolite and replace the sodium ion from the zeolite and gives the insoluble salt MZ2. Here M is nothing but either calcium or magnesium. This is insoluble. Since this is insoluble, we can be easily remove this just by filtering. Hence, we obtain the soft water. Okay, so this is about this ion exchange method. Here, by using this insoluble salt MZ2, we can regenerate or reproduce this zeolite. How? By treating this insoluble salt MZ2 with the aqueous NaCl solution, we can regenerate or reproduce this zeolite. Okay, so this is all about this ion exchange method. Now, let's move on to the fourth method. So, in this category, to remove the permanent hardness of water, that is synthetic resin method. Synthetic resin method. This method is more efficient than the previous method, that is ion exchange method. Because through this method, we can remove all type of cations. Not only calcium and magnesium cations, but also other cations such as even sodium cation and all the type of anions present in the water. Since by this method we can remove all the type of cations and all the type of anions, the resulting water will be a demineralized water or deionized water. What is the meaning of this deionized water? Deionized water means the water which is free from all the cations and anions except H plus and OH minus. Okay. Now, as the name itself suggesting, in this method we are going to use the synthetic resin. The synthetic resin is also called as ion exchange resin. Ion exchange resin. These synthetic resin or ion exchange resins are available in market. Okay. So what are the synthetic resins or ion exchange resin? Synthetic resin or ion exchange resin means they are gained organic molecules. They are big organic molecules with higher molecular masses. And there are two types of this synthetic resin or ion exchange resin. The first type is cation exchange resin. Cation exchange resin. If the bigger hydrocarbon chain R is attached to the acidic groups like COOH or SO3H, then that type of resins are called cation exchange resins. Here R represents the bigger hydrocarbon chain. Bigger hydrocarbon chain. If this hydrocarbon chain attached to the acidic groups like carboxylic group or sulfonic group, then that type of resin is called cation exchange resin. These cation exchange resins will exchange their H plus ions with the cations present in the hard water, such as calcium, magnesium, etc. You know what is cation and anion, right? Cation means the ion which carries positive charge. Anion means the ion which carries negative charge. Okay? So these resins will exchange their H plus ions with the cations present in the hard water. So hence they are called cation exchange resins or simply cation exchangers. Now the second type of this ion exchange resin is anion exchange resins. Anion exchange resin. In a resin, if the bigger hydrocarbon chain R is attached to the basic group such as NH3OH, substituted ammonium hydroxide, then that type of resins are called anion exchange resins. Here R is the bigger hydrocarbon chain and this is basic group. If bigger hydrocarbon chain R attached to the basic group such as NH3OH, that type of resins are called anion exchange resins. And these anion exchange resins will Now you understood about these two. Now let us discuss about the process of demineralization of water. That means how to demineralize the water or how to deionize the water. So in that process there will be two steps. In the step one, the water is passed through the tank which contains cation exchange resins. That means water is first passed through the cation exchange resins. There the H plus ions of the resin will exchange with the cations such as calcium, magnesium, etc. present in the hard water. And I have written down the equation here. Observe, this is a cation exchange resin. This cation exchange resin will exchange its H plus ions with the cations such as calcium and magnesium and release this H plus ions to the water. Okay, that means after passing through the cation exchange resin, the water will become free from all the other cations except H plus ion. And then this water, which contains only H plus ion but not any other cations, is passed through the another tank which contains anion exchange resin. That means in the second step, the same water which is it is passed through the anion exchange resin. During that process, the anion exchange resin will exchange its OH minus ions with the anions present in the hard water such as chloride, sulfate, etc. Okay, observe this equation. So after passing through the second this is second tank that contains anion exchange resin, now the water is free from all the other type of anions except OH minus ions, and these OH minus ions will combine with the H plus ions from the previous step and form the water. So after this process, the water which we get is demineralized water. This is all about the synthetic resin method. Now let us discuss about another little concept. One small concept is left here, that is heavy water. Heavy water, it is represented by D2O. Here D means deuterium. Deuterium, you know that hydrogen has three isotopes: protium, deuterium and tritium. Deuterium is one of the isotopes of hydrogen. If this deuterium forms D2O, that's called heavy water. Its chemical name is deuterium oxide. Okay, and this heavy water is mainly used as moderator in the nuclear reactors. It slows down the fast moving neutrons, hence control the nuclear reaction. Hence it is used in nuclear reactors. And also to study the mechanism of some reactions, also this heavy water is used. And to prepare other deuterium compounds also, this deuterium oxide is used. This is a little information about this heavy water. This completes the chapter hydrogen. I hope you understood all the concepts well. If you have any doubts, please feel free to ask. Okay, and my suggestion is watch all the videos with complete concentration. Even if you don't understand anything at first time, watch it again. You will definitely going to understand. Okay, anyway, thank you and all the best.